On most row crop planters, the depth adjustment is up in this area, and basically is when you're making that depth adjustment, you're changing the relative position between the bottom edge of the depth gauging wheel and the bottom edge of your seed furrow, as established by that double disc seed opener there. And everyone's familiar with making that adjustment, but one thing to kind of point out here is, let's say that you want to plant that seed at, for example, an inch and a half depth. So you set the depth gauge here for an inch and a half. You want to make sure that these depth gauging wheels are in firm contact with the soil and gauging depth. One thing that can happen, and particularly in undisturbed soil, no-till soil conditions, and particularly when the soil is maybe on the dry side of things, that soil can be difficult for that double disc seed opener to penetrate, and maybe, in some conditions, that double disc seed opener will just not penetrate all inch and a half into the soil, but right up, and the bottom edge of those depth gauging wheels will be hanging in midair. So the real way to check that is to lean down and try and spin those depth gauging wheels. Now here we've got the row crop unit up in midair, so we can easily spin these, but when this is setting on the ground and in planting position, you want to make sure that you cannot slip these. If you can start to slip them, you probably don't have enough weight there to really be gauging the depth that way. If that gets to be a problem, the solution for that, of course, is to get more weight or ballast on the row unit. And that's done usually by an adjustment up here on the parallel lengths that attach the row unit to the planter frame. Most planters, older planters, many planters out there use down pressure springs to make that adjustment. And getting more tension on those down pressure springs actually transfers some of the weight from the toolbar frame itself onto the row units to help you penetrate the soil that way. So you can readjust these. For example, here we've got different positions on these springs. Also worthwhile noting on this particular Kinsey planter, we've got two down pressure springs on the right parallel lengths here, two on the left. These probably heavy enough for most no-till conditions. But again, on some maybe older planters or even some newer planters, if they really weren't outfitted for no-till to begin with, you need to check and make sure you've got that kind of capability. If you've only got a couple of springs, maybe you need to double that up and go to four springs. Or if you've got a couple of lighter springs, maybe go to a couple of heavier springs, that type of deal. But you need to be able to have that kind of capability. Newer planters are starting to go to pneumatic systems now, in terms of there'll be an air bladder there to basically transfer that weight that way. But that's the principle. One thing to kind of keep in mind here, you are transferring weight from the toolbar frame itself to do that. And once in a while, particularly on some smaller planters or maybe some older planters that had kind of a lighter frame, once in a while you could start to lose enough weight off that frame that you'd start to not really have good ground contact with your frame transport wheels on the soil surface. And you might think, not a big deal, but usually one or more of those wheels is often hooked up to the seed drive, and so you want to make sure that those are turning appropriately too. So if that's an issue, you might need to add a little ballast to the toolbar frame, but typically, again, just smaller, older planters, you might run into that. One last thing in this whole operation, we want to make sure that the depth wheels are in good firm contact with the soil, but don't overdo it. I mentioned drier soils, undisturbed soils, no-till operation is where we tend to see this more often. If the soil is wet or moist or you know, kind of borderline, should I plant in this or not? First of all, you probably shouldn't be doing it then. But again, if those soils are kind of wet and moist, typically it's a lot easier for that double disc seed opener to penetrate. We won't need nearly as much force to do that. And if you leave these downspring, down pressure springs fully tensioned that way, you're adding a lot of contact pressure on the soil here and compacting soil, and that's not good for early seedling growth either. So you want just enough ground contact there, but not too much. The way this might come into play is, let's say you've been planting in some drier soil conditions and you get rained out of the field and you get back in there and all of a sudden soil conditions have changed, and so you need to lighten up on that pressure. Use enough to make sure you've got contact, but don't overly compact that soil.